It's the small device sparking up lots of discussion.
What do you know about vaping?
I know that some people do it to release stress.
Yeah, I've tried it, but it's not good for you.
10 years ago, we didn't even, you know what vaping was. But today, it's something that is normal.
I just feel the dizziness of it, so then I just kind of stop.
You just vape because you have this tempted, like trying to like stop smoking, but then you go vaping.
Is it helping you stop smoking?
No, it just makes me want to keep smoking.
Vapes or e-cigarettes heat a flavoured liquid which can contain nicotine and turns it into a vapour, a recipe that's got our youth hooked.
On a normal day, we'd have about 50 young people come through and use our drop-in space. I'd say at least half of them probably have a vape in their pocket, and we're dealing with young people as young as 9 years old, up to 18.
This youth centre in West Auckland is open for young people to hang out after school. However, the mentors here are now having to police what students bring to the space.
It's the ability to hide it, it's the ability to conceal it, it's the ability to use it inside and it not set off our alarms. It's seen like it's normal for young people to have a vape. It's cool for young people to have a vape, which is even worse.
The Ministry of Health reports the number of young New Zealanders aged 15 to 17 who vape daily have quadrupled since 2018, a real concern for local schools.
The reality is we've seen an exponential growth in our young people taking up vaping, possibly and probably even people that wouldn't have taken up smoking have taken up vaping. And so we're at the sort of endemic stage where it is rife through all of our communities.
Vapes are banned at schools and teachers are having a tough time monitoring students.
Everything from the punishment penalty side of someone needing a consequence for repetitive or whatever it may be behaviour, through to the technological side of installing vape sensors or whatever it may be. Anything you can think of that schools would normally do to try and stop, we've all been trying all of those things.
Smoke-free advocates are fired up as vapes have taken up the spotlight, while cigarette smoking is on the decline.
We are collecting community submission responses for the new tobacco regulation in and around tightening tobacco control, but also tightening areas in the vaping space. So that's in and around the number of retailers. We currently have 6,000. We're looking at dropping that to 600, which means there's only going to be 33 retailers in Auckland that will sell tobacco, and taking the nicotine out of tobacco so that our people don't get addicted to it.
Others are calling on the government to get tougher on vape stores, even proposing to raise the age restriction to 21 years old.
I sort of like what they've done in Australia in terms of prescription access in some states in Australia, where it's genuinely a get yourself off smoking deal.
We're not dealing with prevention, we're now dealing with recovery. We're having to go to government and try and implement laws post the damage being done. We're trying to go to schools and figure out what are the policies. We're trying to go to ministries and say, what can we do to be a community voice for vaping because it wasn't done before it arrived. I don't know if it's something that we're going to be able to solve, but we're willing to be a part of the fight.
A fight that continues with the hope their efforts won't go up in smokes.